I think Xayah fits here to help withstand some of the dive that will be coming across here from Cloud9. So throwing down the gauntlet, game one, Team Liquid, your job is, so Alfari now needs to take this window to try to push in. Armeo's moving up there to try to help him do it, but Blabber is heading straight back up to top lane, and this could be really good for Cloud9. Remember, no flash on Alfari. Here comes Blabber.
This will turn very violent very quickly. Armeo is stunned up, and Fudge is going in for the first blood in the 1v2. Blabber was not even required, and Cloud9 is about to get a buy one, get one free. Two kills to kick it.
Unleashes the full combo on him, but that won't matter. The bot lane is there. They have the priority. They have the advantage. And Cloud9 gets their 4v2 dive. Here it goes, baby. Tactical with the flash away. Core JJ is left all on his lonesome, and the damage will just pour on in. Seraphine ulti will not find Tactical. Core JJ stays alive. C9 switches it over. Tactical's the first to die, and Core JJ will try to escape. At best, he can hope for an execution. Vulcan wants to shut that down right now. He has his flash ready to go if necessary. Won't even need it. Headbutts them into the turret. It don't matter too much. Perks can get that thing online sooner than anybody can contest it. And that means Cloud9
is posturing to fight. So they want to scrap at this dragon. We'll see. I mean, Fudge is still basing. He's got to get here fast.
Blabber is fearless running in there, and Core JJ is already dead before he can do a damn thing. Team Liquid have lost their support, and Cloud9 have lost none of their bravery. They will continue moving forward towards the Drake Pit, taking control over the river. TL decides they cannot fight any longer.
And bad goes to worse because Alfari tried to TP and Fudge was there. He stopped it. He didn't even have to use the teleport.
No.
Fudge started the base and then realized, all right, my team's going to scrap. I've got to stay around. I need to be able to respond to either the teleport.
Armeo with the ulti. C9 just decides, all right, no more reason to fight. Back up, take the turret. Core JJ and Jensen both moving forward, looking to apply a little bit of wave clear, but not enough. And Cloud9 will take their second turret of the game.
I mean, Vulcan, it looks a little bit silly, but he traded flash, and now they're going in here on Armeo, who has no ulti.
Blabber went for the flash play, but now he's going to be taking too much damage. Tactical grabbing a kill there, and here comes the Scion train. They'll find even more damage.
Watch on the
Vulcan
blank.
Tanking up now in the front line. The shutdown goes over to Tactical here, and that was a big moment for Team Liquid.
They're going to go to Baron. Blabber's dead. Team Liquid may have just turned this game on its head. C9, one fight goes bad. Can they even contest it? I'm not sure. Fudge is still around, but they've got no ulti here on Sven or on Seraphine.
There's no Seraphine ulti at all. The team fight capability so limited. Jensen looking to zone him away, nearly grabbing the kill onto the enemy AD carry. Fudge jumps into the middle, looking to stop everybody, looking to hold him down, slow it down. Fudge running away. A little bit more damage is required to finish him off. And Fudge, the hero of the day, diving in 1v5 to stop the Baron.
Yeah, by a hair's breadth, he survives there, pushing TL off of that Baron. So it just means TL get a couple kills. That's good for them. Gives them a small foothold in the game.
Keep that in mind. Seraphine's ready to go tank up a little bit more. Sven is applying lots of spears to the dragon here. This will be incredibly difficult to try to contest. Vulcan takes a little bit of damage here. Alfari on the front line. Losing about 1/3 HP, down to half now. Dragon at 3K. More damage being applied. Armeo and Blabber both right next to it. You know they want to contest these. Dragon's going to be focused now. It's able to be slain by Team Liquid. And the fight breaks out with the onslaught of shadows into the back line. Everybody on Cloud9 going to be taken very low. Tactical staying alive here with a nice use of the ulti. C9, health bars dropping. And they will not be able to find victory in this team fight. They will not be able to find
Blabber
this dragon.
Has no entryway into the Baron Pit.
And after 20 minutes of Cloud9 domination, it's damage of just 4,780. Everybody else on Cloud9 only adds up to a grand total of like 1,000 more than Jensen. That's just incredible Victor scaling, good team fighting from him. The AoE power of that champion cannot be understated. And now, I'd say the tables have turned, but we threw the damn table out the window onto the front lawn. Team Liquid, they're 400 gold behind. I am sorry, they're about 300 gold in the lead. And they're
they pulled it off there. They're gonna be in an even better spot next time because they are stacking up all of this gold, taking down towers.
They have been doing a good job of enduring this so far. They haven't given away any extra kills. And that's kind of just the name of the game. Try to protect this inhibitor line. Don't let TL have the base.
And TL will take that
Dragon
tier 2.
Soul here in about 20
Armeo
seconds.
Armeo on the flank.
Armeo swooping around here, potentially from behind. Here we go. Alfari's the one taking the damage. Armeo goes after Sven, but now he's into the front line looking for everybody else. Tackle up into the air, bringing it back, getting away here with a flash. Blabber looking to chase him down. Fudge doing the same. Armeo with the onslaught of Shadow says, get the hell off of my carry. Team Liquid are able to find yet another kill for themselves. Fudge looks to continue the fight here, taking the health bars very low. It's a one-for-one trade, making it a one-for-two. Perks running away here. Armeo again! The shutdown onto Tackle's gonna come through, but it's still a triple kill over to Jensen.
Was he able to dodge the early engage and free hit throughout that fight? He's got a pea shooter. He's doing nothing to stop.
The jungler is not actually in the pit. Might just take the Blast Cone here. Armeo's gonna take a lot of damage, but the Blast Cone ends up getting him away, still with about 60% HP. Vulcan's already activated Alistar ulti here in the pit, taking a lot of damage. Now Vulcan has to be pulled to safety over by Sven. Alfari tanks up everybody. It's Fudge into the back. It's Fudge grabbing a kill on a tactical. Oh, so many shutdowns coming out, and Cloud9 will destroy this fight. Team Liquid, only their front line remains. Alfari is mortal after all. And that was a huge 4-for-nothing for C9.
That is absolutely massive. And they're going towards mid lane here, looking like they want to try to go potentially towards an inhibitor and then peel back for the Baron maybe. I don't think that the spawn timers are long enough to go for an end, but they may prove me wrong. They are posturing so aggressively. The fact that they didn't even stop for the Baron for even a second says they maybe think they can end this.
10 seconds on Tactical and Core JJ. 15
they're
on Jensen,
forward.
20 on Alfari. It's Armeo versus the world, and Armeo's trying to cut the way.
Tactical in four.
He goes right back in, looking for some of the minions here. Core JJ has also respawned and rejoined the effort. Armeo's still tanking up everybody. He's drawn all the minions away. Armeo will die, but the Nexus.
And Seraphine has ultimate.
Vulcan just dies immediately, and Core JJ goes in. Sven's going to be double killed. Jensen's able to find the damage. C9 just falls over.
They got erased. I mean, Vulcan, I think, had his ultimate there. Looked like he just didn't get it off. Sven goes down immediately.
What an incredible back and forth the past 2 minutes of this game have been, Azale.
No kidding. And I mean, Cloud9 now are going to be spent the additional time, allowing Team Liquid to respawn. Let's watch this one more time. He goes in, and that was CoreJJ stunning him right. A perfect CC combo around this dragon. They are still on Soul Point. We'll see if they can get it, but TL is here in time, and they are posturing effectively. Jensen on the
here
side.
We go. Let's see what they got. Cloud9, control over the Drake. Team Liquid coming in. Drake's gonna be taken down and stolen away by Armeo. You gotta be kidding me. Vulcan's the target here as Team Liquid's able to focus him down through the ulti. Onslaught of shadows into the middle of everyone. Armeo about to die, but the stasis keeps him alive. Tactical finishes off Blabber, and Fudge just has too much focus on him to do anything in that back line. Alfari is marching down mid lane. There is 30 seconds on Blabber and Fudge. Vulcan will be back alive here in 10. We'll see if Team Liquid believes they can end or not. Remember, they are only a four-man squad. Armeo did have to die in the last fight. Alfari goes in. Scion ulti won't find a whole lot, but we can see the turrets start to fall very rapidly. Perks at about half HP. Alfari backing away now. Doesn't want to continue tanking up the turrets. Alfari very, very low. Sven coming in for the damage here. CoreJJ wants to engage. Perks grabbing the kill on Alfari. C9 looking to pick up two, and there it is for the Seraphine.
20% health. But you've never actually heard him yet. It's just so difficult. The gold graph back and forth here this game. Traditional scaling crit marksman.
Yep.
This is what that looks like as Tactical is set off to potentially be in trouble here, but now he's able to escape with the ulti. Jensen coming right back into the fight. Lots of wombo, lots of combo. Vulcan's tanking up, but Blabber's gonna be taken low. Fudge trying to apply the pressure into the back line with Core JJ being the first to die. Cloud9 go 1-for-0 here in this exchange, and now they're marching up towards the Baron pit. They're saying, all right, you want the Drake, you can have it, but we're going for Baron.
But that's Soul, so that's pretty big deal there. It's not just that Baron for Dragon trade, it is for the Soul, but they didn't feel that they would be able to enter the fight through the Victor, and that is the key difference here. So they are going for more power right now. They're saying, we've got to end this game. It's getting
Watch
away.
The little cooldown icon there on the side. Victor's ultimate is now 1/4 off cooldown.
Yeah. it's looking like a 30, 40 second cooldown, all told. Yep. And they do get the mid lane inhibitor, so good job, Blabber.
Into the enemy base. They'll grab inhibitor.
Do they go for the fight? I think C9 may just try to collapse on them from both sides, and this could be a game-deciding fight.
This will be an incredible ending, one way or the other. Inhibitor has fallen. Fudge running away. He's isolated from the rest of the team, and Cloud9 are coming in for the pincer assault now. Vulcan already using the ulti. Armeo running away, trying to disengage. Vulcan thrown into the back line here with a lot of damage being placed down onto the front line.
Tactical's
a huge
dead.
Shutdown! Tactical is gone, but so is Perks. They've still got Jensen alive on the side of TL, and they're still in the Cloud 9 base. It is a one for one. Both junglers are still alive if this turns into an Elder Drain.
Of those timers. Armeo may get jumped on by Vulcan. No.
They're going to force. Here comes the TB.
They're forcing the Elder Drake. They're saying, you got to answer now. We've got Kalista and we've got Blabber. They want this objective fight going down. Tactical needs to find his way into this, but he needs to avoid Fudge in the process. Fudge is coming around from the flank. Tactical's got him locked down. Fudge is running away. Alfari looking to waste some time here on the front line. Make sure they're not able to burn down the Drake. Vulcan disengages. Fudge disengages. Injured health bars on both sides. Tactical doing a good job trying to whittle these guys away, but there's so much healing on Seraphine. Blabber tries to back up yet again. Tactical with so much damage. They're going in here for the fight now. Team Liquid. Tactical's able to take down Blabber. Elder Drake still alive. Sven gets a return kill to the core JJ. Perk's going to be forced to tank up now with Armeo taken out next. The
Tactical
dragon goes over to Tactical. The dragon goes over to Team Liquid. The fight goes to Team Liquid. And the ace for Team Liquid.
That'll do it. It's the game-winning fight. Tactical gets the Elder Dragon there. It is not the Kalista. It is not the Udyr.
You want to talk about his Tristana jumps? Fine. But you better not be disrespecting the man's team fight prowess. The victory in game one, 20-19, 48 minutes in. TL started off with a win.
Wow, what a game there to start us off here. The mid-season showdown.
Yeah, but all three of them together, good lord.
So this is very different strategies being brought to the table here.
Out of
Team Mana, yes, he has have some Corrupting Potion charges, but Alfari's still sitting pretty at full health. Blabber has wrapped around behind, though, and Alfari is going to be in mini here. They're going to go.
Okay, Blabber timing it perfectly. Coming in with a devastating charge, and the flash will not matter for the second.
Try to have him relentlessly shove in the TF. Then it becomes a lot harder to move and make these plays. They're going topside again. No flash.
Oh, Fudge has already started things off here with the ulti. Alfari tries to hop away, but mid-air he just...
to take that away as an early win condition for Cloud9, who wants the group and flashes. So I don't think TL will contest this one.
Nope.
They're going to be happy to have taken the first dragon and push back the soul.
We do have a lot more playmaking on the table. It's Armeo back up here in the top side yet again. Alfari with the Mega Gnar slam into the wall. Twisted Fate ult also been used here. Perks is the one who will now find himself as the target. Armeo with a bear slap immediately, looking to find the damage on the Cloud9 mid laner. But with Blabber entering into the fight, it's Armeo who is now in trouble and forced to flash over the wall. Onslaught of Shadows finds him and knocks him back, and Armeo is shockwaved.
As long as you're talking about solo queue and stuff, but I think it makes a lot of sense here. You know, he's saying, who cares about the 1v1? I'm just going to be farming in my tower anyway. If I can have
back in,
Tactical is towards the Gale Force, so this is on hit. Suspected as much when I saw that it was the lethal tempo.
Right.
Armeo, remember, no flash. They're going for it.
Armeo is the target, and the target is found. Cloud9, take down the enemy.
So he'll just have to walk it on back up to the top lane here. You can see him just trying to get through the brush. He finds Fudge waiting on him, but it's not just Fudge. It's Fudge and Perks and Blabber and Team Liquid showing up for the backup, though. Armeo running in there. Jensen makes his way into the play now as well underneath the enemy tier one turret, his own, excuse me. Fudge now caught out, flashes over the wall, but the gold card will follow. Wild Cards comes after, and Team Liquid.
Now.
Shelly has been summoned up in mid lane. Jensen rotating over to the Drake now. TP coming in for Cloud9, and it's Fudge with the ulti on arrival. Armeo walks away with about 300 HP. Alfari's going to be tanking here in the back, trying to draw some aggro over to himself. Jumps over the wall, gets away. Dragon resets, but it's still Cloud9 with five-man control over the river, and they will take that objective.
Nicely done. They push him back there. They don't. Instead of the rapid fire second, we'll see if he wants to go towards rapid fire next or if he'll go towards more of that kind of battle style and complete the stopwatch into his Zonias. That is a build that I know high becoming in.
A TP showing up. Here comes the Twisted Fate ulti. Team Liquid's looking to collapse, and here they go. The target will be Perks. The chain CC comes down. Welcome to the League of Everfrost. Alfari grabs the first kill. Tactical takes the second.
Oh, they want Baron.
Here we go, C9. They've got the ulti ready for Blabber. They know that they can try to flip this. 50-50 is what it could be. Alfari goes over the wall with a Mega Gnar, and they got him locked down. Blabber's almost dead, but almost will not happen just yet. Jensen
Armeo's
with a
save
to keep himself alive. Armeo's still in the Baron. Fudge is about to die, and Tactical ends up getting kill. The Baron is taken low. The Baron is taken down. Team
combo, combo team yes, fight sir. Comp. And when you lose the
Here
wombo out of the combo, what are you going to do? Vulcan now might be in a position where he's caught out, but they're putting the focus on to Sven. Instead, the man's already down. Kill over to Armeo as C9 jumps in and looks to reverse things now.
Perk's going to be in a really bad spot. Tactical takes him out. Armeo continuing the chase, and Blaber has to run. They'll look to try to find just a little bit more lockdown. They don't have to look very hard. They've already got three kills for only the one. Alfari's looking to say, let's make it four. It's Team Liquid after all. Here we go. Fudge is not long for this world, and TL is loving that team fight.
They are so far ahead. 5,000 gold lead. No sign of soul here for C9 whatsoever. With the Baron buff still having a minute on it, they're going to pick up even more towers. They're going to get bot. They're going to get mid, if not a second mid tower. And TL have flying in. TF ulti coming across. Core JJ overlapping across the top with the ulti, finding the rest of them.
Because these guys can threaten so many different sites at once. You've got the Gnar, you've got the Udyr. Tactical can shove waves up so incredibly quickly. He's running away from Fudge. And remember, Fudge can't just ult that. Sivir spell shields the ulti and runs away, so Fudge was trying to get in range to Q him, but just couldn't be done. Couldn't quite close the gap there. Team Liquid's able to run for now. Core JJ in a really bad spot. Flashing away, trying to stay alive. He pops his ulti defensively. He's trying to buy as much time as he can. The rest of the team will not arrive, and Cloud9 gets themselves a kill.
They do get a kill, but what can you get after it? There's nothing on the map. And you know, that previous TF ulti, it may look a little bit strange. We'll see his tactical has to retreat here.
Oh, he don't got to retreat much further. Blaber taking a whole lot of damage.
Oh,
there we go! Why retreat when you can go forward? Cloud9, that trademark aggression in the enemy base.
They got a tier 2 tower, and they're dying at the inhib here. Alfari cut the wave, though, so C9 will have to back it up, but a couple big kills for them. They pick up three. They close the gold gap a little bit, and now they're looking for Alfari here. Perks is behind him.
Alfari's ready to transform. The shockwave keeps him locked down, but he jumps away in time. Now he's got to get all the way out. The continued CC, the continued lockdown. Cloud9 has turned this game. You already talked again about how valuable that Cloud Soul could be for either side, and now it's Team Liquid. We're on soul point, so C9 will up. 6,000 HP left for the Baron. Cloud9 looking to burn it, taking it very low. Can they actually get it down in time? No, Team Liquid's able to make their way in. Tactical's already down. Cloud9, big fight, double kill over to Perks. Looking for even more. Team Liquid joins the party, only to be massacred. It's the Red Wedding, and Cloud9 have room for every guest.
Cloud9, it's such a big play for them. They set up the Baron. They've been denying vision for time and time again here. And they commit to it. They got the IE on Sven. They have four items on Perks. When you die with Gale Force, he is kicking himself and saying, if only I reacted, if only I positioned that little bit better, that would have been a different fight.
And you can see it on the damage charts.
Yes,
right?
Sir.
Tactical did less Cloud damage. Now have the game back in their control, and it's Cloud9 pushing down the bottom lane. This is the kind of a squad that just goes for the throat right
can't,
here.
Can't
Why
split.
Not?
You can't split against this. It's a five-man with the most insane engage ever. They're going to push you back off your tower, and that tower's just gone.
They had to back up. As soon as they land the slow onto Tactical and Blaber is threatening with that devastating charge, there is no choice but to retreat. First inhibitor already down, still 90 seconds left to go here in the Baron. The Drake is also alive. C9 can stop off and take that if they want to.
Yeah.
And it looks like that might be the play here, or they could rotate over.
Oh, they're going to try to cut off Alfari. It's a TP behind him. Will they have time?
Game-winning move. Immediate Malphite ulti, baby. Look at that.
Up to the top side of the map. They had the pre-planned ward. They get behind him. This is mid and hip gone. How far will Cloud9 push? Do they want to try to go for the end? They don't have Malphite ult, but they do have Shockwave. They do have Rakan and Hecarim ultis.
And they've got a team fight comp. Let's see what they can do with it. Fudge eating a lot of damage. Shockwave forces out of Zonya's, but won't find any other success. Blaber's got to retreat now too. Both Nexus turrets still online, although that first one is just about dead. You've still got Sven with plenty of HP. The Kai'Sa is such
a huge threat
here. Jensen with a gold card locked in. That's going to fade away here in just a moment. Cloud9.
That is recognizing multiple steps ahead. Where would Alfari go to escape from this
play? Ready to apply similar pressure to the last remaining inhibitor standing.
I mean, you remember what they did at the bot lane? They pop the ghost, they move forward, they say, hey, we're gonna dive you, we're gonna dive you, back it up, back it up. If you do that, you can just take the tower, but it's a TP flank here from Alfari. This could be the game right now.
Cloud9's gonna play this right. Alfari with a Mega Gnar. Three people slammed up into the wall. Alfari backing away now. Cloud9 hasn't lost a single person yet. Shockwave's not gonna find much of anything. Cloud9 taken very low. Fudge is already dead. Tactical goes forward with the Gale Force. He wants the second kill here onto Blabber. Seen
to be removed from Summoner's Rift so rapidly. Fudge getting caught out. Gargoyle Stoneplate will buy him a little bit of extra time. The Baron has already been taken. Core JJ goes down. Fudge goes in. And Tactical is about to drop. The Shockwave finds its way onto Armeo. Perks is already godlike. Another shutdown coming through for Sven. And Cloud9 find everything they came for. Alfari and Jensen must run. It is a 5v2 here on the map. Make it a 5v1. Alfari the last to die. Sven is unstoppable. And Cloud9 answers in game two.
They've got it. Fudge TP's right at the top side. They got the Baron minions. One tower between them and victory. Cloud9, make it happen.
Jensen cannot hold the line here. There is only so much Twisted Fate can accomplish on his own. Another close game, a banger of a series so far, and Cloud9 tie it up.
What more can you ask for?
Scaling bot laner, fresh, a lot of utility to actually pull people away from the Nocturne ult. One of the few answers immobile carries actually have to Nocturne ult. But he just went back up towards the top side to get to those Krugs. And he's actually going to cancel the recall. They're going to look for a wraparound because Alfari is trying to reset.
Up. Fudge has already auto-attacked the barrel. Fudge walking up here, keeping him locked down with a tether. Duskbringer will hit the target. And Blabber goes in with a spell shield. Three times in a row, it is first blood for Cloud9 in the top lane.
They're doing such a good job of actually managing the waves and putting Alfari in these awkward positions. Because of what I talked about earlier, where you are the person who TP'd back, you are TPing in to trade with someone who hasn't left, and this is not going to work, Armeo. You got to be careful.
Oh, no, Armeo is locked down. Fudge picks up
the game. They'll grab that one. Doesn't look like we'll see any sort of a contest here from the side of C9. So there it is. Infernal.
Core JJ is on the rotation.
Ooh. Core JJ with the death sentence. Exhaust down into Blabber. Jensen's going to be brought in. Shockwave hits the mark, and Blabber, see you later.
The Ludens, but seeing that the Ruby Crystal is in there, I'm thinking it's Everfrost.
Well, only time will tell what we've got. We also can see the lost chapter here for Victor and Orianna, both in the mid lane. So whether or not they go for more offensive options or for the utility of the Everfrost, we'll see on that.
In their element, two ultis have gone down there that have gotten them absolutely nothing. Nice triple barrel. They're going for Fudge.
Fudge in trouble, flashing away, trying to stay alive, but TL does not care. They grab themselves the first kill, but with the TP showing up, it might just turn into the 2-for-1 special. Perks is trying to run away. He has to flash.
So it just costs him both summoners to actually get out alive.
And Fudge does have that Everfrost. And yes, that's super effective against a champion that has to run up to you with no gap. And it looks like bye-bye C9 mid lane turret. And with that final piece of the puzzle picked up, Team Liquid has cleared out all three of the tier ones of Cloud9. C9 will be able to respond at least by grabbing the tier one turret of Team Liquid.
The dragon has been started by C9.
Team Liquid moving in. Armeo with a turbo Kim tank ready to go, and Vulcan has a massive four-man initiation. They're trying to get Tactical away, but Blabber is the first to die. Vulcan's about to be the second with Sven into the back line, but nobody else is with them. A double kill for Alfari, and a 3-for-nothing for Team Liquid. Armeo wants to make it four. He's gone a little bit deep. Is he too far in? Yes, he is, and Perks will get a return kill. Team Liquid still looking for that fourth one here. Fudge staying alive for the moment. A little bit more damage coming out. They don't quite have enough. And away. So yes, Cloud9 are able to pick up a bonus kill on the back end, but that's all they got. They lost three, and more importantly, Azale, it's soul point for TL.
It's absolutely huge there for TL. Blabber got close to taking Tactical down, and Vulcan, credit to him, he had a great engage. Look at this, flash, catches 3-4 there. They get the ulti in onto Tactical, but Exhaust is there. And when you get exhausted as that Nocturne, unless you are monstrously ahead, it's just not gonna happen. And you see that the Kai'Sa came across, but by the time he actually got back there, there was nothing really happening. TL just feel like they've answered what C9 brought to the table in this game. This is the most in control.
And this Team Liquid that remember is still playing with a substitute jungler is really, really challenging Cloud9 here so far. And I may have just cast her, cursed him. Cloud9 get a shutdown on the Team Liquid mid laner.
Very nicely done. They go to the side lanes. 5v5s aren't working. This is more what I expected from their composition.
And Blabber has no ulti. He's too far. This is just gone, I think.
Yeah, Baron's down to 2k HP. Team Liquid looking to stay on this. Perks into the Zhonya's. The ulti continues coming down. Baron Nashor goes over to Team Liquid, but now they got to disengage. Vulcan's able to jump in, lock down three. Damage goes out, but Jensen pops fit. Perks is going on a killing spree now. Everybody else from Team Liquid looking to run away because Cloud9 is here to slay. They take down four.
It is well done. They secure it, but what about the fight? Armeo is low. Zven, beautiful ulti into the side, just gets deleted by Jin.
4,000 HP left on the Drake. They're going in. 3,000 HP left. Aphelios ulti not finding a whole lot here, but Vulcan's engage does not find anyone. He's already dead. Now into the back part of the pit. Armeo's going to be taken very low here with a flashback out with a shockwave in, and the dragon goes over to Zven. Cloud9.
Elsewhere on the map, and no
right
for sure.
Tactical.
He's standing behind Tactical. This is not a dumb play. Okay. Whoever has ulti.
Blue Trinket already in there. Now we got the control ward placed down in the back part of the pit. I think they're going to try to finish this. Blabber's ready to go in.
He
Blabber steals the Baron! Cloud9's jungler working some miracles. Yes, he dies after the fact, but that was huge for C9. Ulti summoned up. Armeo going in, sidesteps the Everfrost. Needs to try to lock these guys down a little bit harder. Vulcan looks for an interrupt here with some of the CC. Gravity well placed down.
If Armeo doesn't walk up to whack the Baron and stands at max range, the pig does not potentially see him.
Plus 880. And now they'll take down the tier 2 turret here in the mid lane. Tie up the turret count in the game. And once again, we have a game that could at any point be decided by a single team fight.
Man, I've got to say, C9 gets themselves in these positions where I feel like they've lost the game, but they just do not give up. They keep finding ways to make things happen. It's the same thing, really, that we saw in game number one where they whipped this all early game comp, they fell behind, but then it's a 50-minute game where they just never say die, and it feels, again, similar here. And TL are struggling to really force the fight they want, and here goes C9.
Here it is, Blabber into the back line once more. Armeo's gonna be the target now, forced to flash and run away. Vulcan with a disengage. Gangplank ulti continues finding a lot of damage. Stasis keeps Vulcan alive. Shockwave will be flashed away from. And
ready to
contest here. They know they can't give it away.
Fast.
You didn't defend it twice to give it away on the third one. Team Liquid under the Drake. Vulcan here into the fight. Beautiful shockwave on three, but is it enough? Yes, it is! Team Liquid with a double kill here for the top lane. Perks dies for the first time. Zven wants to kite it out, but it will not happen. Not today. Alfari's got the auto attack. Alfari's got the triple kill. Dragon be damned. Jensen Shockwave, one game three.
Team Liquid finally find their fight. They've had the advantage for so long. And Cloud9 can hold on no longer. TL marching down mid.
Team Liquid with the late game team fight with a team fight comp marching into the enemy base. They're on Nexus turrets. This was another hard fought win. Vulcan is back alive, but no one else will be able to join him. He's trying to stop minions, but it's not going to do a damn thing. It's Team Liquid taking game three and taking us to match point.
Welcome back, team fighting. But this does give you the additional playmaking. You land a bubble, that can be a game changer. You land that Gragas engage, that can change the game as well. I mean, you don't drop a pink ward over the wall unless you are thinking about doing something about it. I think, unfortunately, for C9, they are too little too late.
Do it again. Alfari with the ward over the wall. But here comes Blabber! Alfari's knocked backwards. The cast knocks him to the side. Not ideal placement, but good enough. One, two, three, four.
Going hard for it and trying to ult in and steal it and take a fight where I think they would have been flanked. They're going to be able to grab the dragon, and now you just want to disengage, but CoreJJ says no.
CoreJJ is not going to let him. Blabber's trying to run away. Remember, the onslaught of shadows can get him over the wall. He's out.
And Blabber is left alone to take care of this drake, and he'll pick that one up. So, oh, but the response from Team Liquid on the other side, immediately they're grabbing the rift. Can't die from it. He's tanky enough to not worry about that. So then Zoe's not able to throw everyone else away. And there you go. Turret dis-
members are in the area. Zven may want to finish this off, but they've spotted Udyr now, and Cloud9 did start going back towards mid lane, so this does get a little bit dicey.
On four players, plus Turbo Kim Tank also gives a little bit of extra magic resistance. Yep. You can see another Magic Mantle in Core JJ's inventory too. So Perks is guaranteeing
how a fight has to be played out when you are walking blind into a Zoe versus when you are first to the dragon. The Zoe has to walk into you. They want to play around this area, start to fish for poke, start to fish for engage. But meanwhile, Alfari is creating advantages on that bottom side.
Yeah, Alfari grabbing the tier one area right now. Team Liquid, they know they're going to have to go into this. They know that they have to deal with the Zoe that has control over the area, and they got to figure out how to do it. It's going to be a TP play coming in. Hecarim goes in with the onslaught of shadows, but they're still surviving for now. A lot of damage down to Core JJ. Blabber's going to be taken out first with the Root coming through. Armeo grabs the kill. C9 now trying to back up a little bit. Perks with some nice damage onto Jensen. Lands the Drowsy onto Tactical, who goes up into the ulti, but he's popped by Sven. Very nicely done from C9. They will lose their support in trade. Fudge buying some time here with the zone.
Bend over the wall.
Another sleep comes through. Perks doing a lot of work. Core JJ is going to be taken down, but again, it's going to be a trade kill. Perks and Sven again. Soul over to Cloud9.
It's the European reunion. Sven and Perks coming up
faster on this play. Should be rewarded with this tier one here. Looking to try to get that mid.
Okay, cast comes down, but it don't find nothing. Fudge getting caught, but buying time. Nice counterattack from Cloud9. Tactical already having to use the ulti with a flash into the Blade Caller. Sven is now in trouble. The Hourglass, the stopwatch will not be able to keep him alive. And Cloud9 lose
sort of a steal, but it's such a low chance here.
Okay, Core JJ has jumped in right on top of where Perks is going to be waiting. Forces him to use the stolen flash to get away. Baron Nashor over to Team Liquid.
Trying to hold them back instead of just entering the lane. But because Armeo pushes in mid, they've got to respond there. And as a result, you lose the bot lane tower.
Here, but Perks gets away in time. We'll see a little bit of damage coming out from Jensen. Team Liquid falling back
and
the team. Tactical is asleep. He's in trouble with the onslaught of shadows over the wall. Tactical is down. Cloud9 find the enemy AD carry with Core JJ having a flash over the wall. Fudge looking to go after him, but Jensen takes him down. Armeo's in full retreat, but Sven has a killer instinct. Team Liquid have lost two of their players, their AD carry and their jungler. They cannot contest for this Elder Drake any longer.
Yeah, they're staying around, but the health bars are too low. They're still moving back here, but Perks is behind them, and he does have an additional flash. He's going to look.
This is madness. Alfari forced to use the stopwatch here as he tries to go forward. They're standing on top of the gravity well that Jensen has created. A little bit of a safe spot there. Jensen trying to move forward, looking to contest this here one more time. Nice interrupt coming through. Shutdown goes out. Cloud9 will take the Drake. They'll take the fight, and they will eviscerate team.
Knocks him back. Gragas ulti on top. He did not get to touch the keyboard again after that. That was so well layered. Fudge with the follow-up after Blabber, after Perks, land the initial play. That was a big play. That is...
And they have a 5v4 for a minute with both buffs. It's over. Yep. You just lose off of that almost impossible steal. So
outside the pit. So not give an opportunity to try to steal there. And now it's about loss mitigation. How much are you willing to give up here as DL? You don't want a hard fight. You don't want to fight into Soul, Elder, and Baron. At the very least, you have to wait out the Elder, which has 20 seconds. Cloud9, on the other hand, are trying to force during this small window they have left, 15 seconds on it. I think they'll just be given the inhib, but unlikely that they can get the fight.
They should be able to take two, because remember, they did open up the mid lane inhibitor as well. So while the Elder won't give them a team fight, it will give them two inhibitors for free, which brings us to that point that we've mentioned in
previous... Trying to push out these waves and prevent that from happening. I don't think it's going to be synced up on this wave, but on the
finding any hit.
This wave.
Doesn't matter, though. Here it is, baby. Here's the pressure. There goes the Tier 3 turret in the bottom lane. Cloud9 trying to make
flank.
Their move.
This is going to be the fight.
This is it. It all comes down to this. Cloud9 are hanging on right now. Let's see. Can Alfari find the angle that he needs? He's into the Mega Nari. Looks to make the play. It's a big three-man swipe, but it won't do much. It won't do anything. Alfari's going to be tanking up now into the back line. Tactical under pressure here yet again. Vulcan going after him. Looking to find the kill, and he's got it. Tactical is down. Core JJ is down. Cloud9 are marching at the Nexus. Blabber leads the charge, and the rest of his men fall in behind him. Ladies and gentlemen, do you like League of Legends? Because we're going to game five.
I hear something in the distance, Flowers. Silver Scrapes, baby. Let's go.
I don't think so, though. Oh.
Silas. Look at the ultimates you can steal here. You talk about Cho'Gath having that ulti. How about Silas
and Blood? Is this five games in a row? Ignite's been dropped. Vulcan's on the chase. Vulcan with a flash. Vulcan with a pulverize. Alfari knows it. Even if he flashes, it does not matter.
Mayo stole away a couple of camps. He's still only one camp behind his opponent in Blabber, but Blabber's level 4 against level 3. He's also Udyr against Tekkarim. Blabber with the flash, trying to lock Mayo down. Perks comes over the wall. He goes for the E. He goes for the damage. He goes all the way.
Early lead that they can try to work with here to now take a dragon to move it around the map, and they're just doing this expertly.
Things are back carries, so things are as expected, but it has led to a good lane state, a good game state overall for the side of Cloud9. Perks coming up into the top side. Level 6 and level 6 versus 4 and 5. I'm going to tell you right now who wins that one, and his name is Perks.
Nice. That next Rift Herald as that next point of attack, and they are quickly moving.
Let him play his game and then just say, oh, I'll team fight him later. No. Perks' activity this game has been so impressive, and now they're going in yet again. Core JJ cannot get away, and Perks is on a killing spree.
Anything you can do, I can right back in with his own ulti. No chance of escaping. 3 early kills, and it's a TP flank from Perks. They want more.
Oh, baby, they aren't done yet. We have a TP showing up from TL. Alfari with a flash away. TL want to try to outplay this. Armeo's got to fall back a little bit further here. Alfari stuck in the front line, goes for the damage, goes for the burst, gets rid of Fudge. It'll be a 1-for-1. Team Liquid now having to fall back even further. Pulverize will not find the mark on a Jensen who continues his retreat. Armeo, now the target of Perks with the stolen onslaught of shadows.
Grabbing a kill for themselves there. I feel like this is the first little misstep we've seen from Perks. Looked like he got a bit greedy. Core has no flash.
Oh, Core JJ, what are you doing, man? He's face checking now, but they're able to turn it around. Why on earth am I doubting Core JJ? The one man.
But they will take that mid lane turret incredibly low. It's already 2 Drake advantage here for the side of C9, but now the fight's breaking out. Core JJ coming in for the counterattack. Vulcan's already dead. And Fudge cannot arrive in time. Perks is still looking for some damage. Armeo is going to be killed off next. Perks having to fall back a little bit. Sven doing the same. Fudge continues leading the charge, but Tactical has rejoined the fight too. Core JJ tossing Sven back over his shoulder. Tactical into the back line, looking for the damage. Sven going to be taken very low. Core JJ going to be taken down. Sven with the reset.
Got to dodge the W.
Fudge the kill onto Alfari. Jensen's looking to stay alive, but Perks is saying no. Team Liquid lose 4. Perks wants to make it 5. Everfrost says no problem. Double kill over to the mid lane from C9.
What a team fight from Cloud9, from how Sven managed to stay alive against Tactical and Core JJ. One-way trip, and I'm not sure this is going to be where they make their stand. So Cloud9 wins a massive. Sven smiling. He knows that was huge for the team, and now they are going for it. Oh, this is too much.
Okay, Perks is trying to make the moves here. The Chaos Storm might finish the job, but it's so close, but still.
Does get shut down. Jensen TPing back out on the map. They're trying to collapse.
Core JJ is going in. They're going after Sven with the exhaust already down. They need a little bit more damage, but they can't quite find it. Core JJ now going to be stuck. The fight turning around. Sven on a killing spree. Team Liquid overextending into the trap set down by C9. Blabber continues running forward, but he has to be careful.
Here
one more auto
Perks.
Attack might be able to finish him off. Alfari over the wall. He needs a little bit more, but Perks is back into the back lines with the onslaught of shadows. Tactical will try to survive, but it will not happen. Alfari's trying to walk away. Cho'Gath is a big tanky boy, but he's slower than Sin. And Cloud9 will take him out of the picture.
Are they going to go to Baron on spawn?
Game 5, 20-minute Baron Nashor.
How insane has this performance been? They just need to play this slow. Buy time for the respawning Perks. He finds the ulti he wants. He comes in from behind. Legendary performance from Perks, the most decorated Western League of Legends player of all time, showing what people are talking about when they are referencing the Perks playoff buff.
He's got more kills than the whole enemy team. It is 8-6. Not Cloud9 versus Team Liquid, Perks versus Team Liquid. That is just incredible here from him in this game. Cloud9 as a whole, doing the lane swap, having the Sion take the jungle camps. Everything is impressive about this game.
They're looking Alfari's for the
bike. Alfari's going to get caught out now. Gravity well placed down to try to keep him alive here a little bit. Armeo going in. Armeo going out in a body bag. Sven is unstoppable.
Is this the victory march? He's dead. That's 30 seconds. They have Baron this early on. For 130, they are pushing forward. Will they continue to posture forward, or will they back up to try to extend the gold lead? It looks like they've got to decide. Do you give up soul and wait for later, or do you fight now?
Oh, Core JJ, he's over the wall. He's grabbed by Perks, but he gets back out in time. Vulcan continuing to zone. Alfari's in the pit. The Dragon goes over to C9, but what about the fight? Vulcan will be killed off first. Tactical grabbing a kill on that. It is a one-for-one trade.
Oh, here, Infernal.
23 minutes.
And they are snowballing. I mean, look at the items on Perks here. Because Cloud9 came into this game 5 with a killer instinct, with the best pre-planned level 1.
Hey, look at that! My big brain co-commentator's brain has once again flexed its muscles, and Fudge is flexing all over Team Liquid. Armeo's already down and out. They'll pick up another one here on the back end, too, with Core JJ dying next. Tactical with a killer instinct, but it will not matter. Fudge is chasing him down. There's the third kill. There's number 4 as Alfari falls over. It's a double kill for Perks. Jensen can do nothing but walk away as Cloud9 go for the victory march right now. They've got the Baron. The inhibitor has respawned. That'll only buy them a couple of extra moments. Jensen knows there's nothing left to do here. Cloud9, they will take down their greatest rival in Team Liquid. They won the regular season. They stayed in the upper bracket. And Cloud9 are your first ever mid-season showdown champions.